Agriculture is a large industry in Guyana. There are vast lands available for the growth of this industry, which provides food security and rewarding markets, both locally and internationally. It is considered one of the most important productive industries in Guyana and accounts for 1/3 of Guyana's gross domestic product and 30% of the country's employment as of 2018. The agriculture industry continues to grow, providing bountiful opportunities in agro-processing. Hi there, I'm Ashley Scotland, welcoming you to Flavours Uncapped, a program produced by the Guyana Manufacturing and Services Association, designed to highlight some of Guyana's agro-processors, their products, and most importantly, how you too can get involved in this growing sector by becoming your very own entrepreneur. Moringa, or what we call saijan, has many health benefits. It is more than just adding extra flavor to a curry. Moringa is well known for making bones healthier. It has a high source of calcium and phosphorus. Its anti-inflammatory properties help to treat conditions such as arthritis and may also heal damaged bones. Moringa is easy to grow in Guyana, and Nature's Finest has created a way in which you can get your daily dose from their locally produced herbal teas. Let's learn more.
5 years ago, I was diagnosed with cervical cancer. And pharmaceutical drugs wasn't helping. I called my dad and he told me to use 5 different kinds of herbs. And I did, and it worked, and prayers and herbs make I'm alive today. So I wanted to help others. One day I gave my friend the tea without it being packaged, and she tried it, but she was trying it using another tea. So she decided to use it by itself. And she loved it, and she called me and told me, why don't I supply Guyanese population with it? The response was good. The first person that sold was GMC, yeah, the marketing. And when I went back, like 2 weeks after, I asked them, I said, what happened to the tea? And they said, it sold out. I thought persons want to buy it because you could easily go at border and pick up herbs, but the response was good. I have 3 persons that supply me the raw materials, the different kinds of herbs. Then when it come into the factory, we have to pick them, wash them, dry them, grind it, and then package it with our machines. Most of the work is done by the machines. The only ones that we do manually is pick it and wash it. You can find Nature's Teas in supermarkets like GMC, Nigel, Survival, Andrews, Go Fresh. I had many challenges along the way, especially financial challenges. And because of the fact that it's a local product, some supermarkets didn't want to put it on their shelves. Thank God for Small Business Bureau. They had given me a grant, and that helped. They make it a bit easier because they had a lot of workshop where you go and you learn a lot. So then it become a little easier. So you learn how to package your stuff well so that persons would buy it and so on. I'm encouraged to do more and to go a lot farther. My vision is to see Nature's Finest all over the world, in every home, in every country. So my advice to any person that wants to venture into this kind of business is, yes, you can go ahead. You will have challenges, but I believe that challenges make you stronger. Don't give up. Nothing in life comes easy. You have to keep working at it, and eventually you will get better.
The wellness of the body is very important, and we as Guyanese certainly know herbal teas. I would always recommend using natural products once they're available. And they are right here in Guyana, made by Guyanese. In this segment of Flavours Uncapped, we have a sweet treat for you. Gordon Hunt is another agro-processor, and he produces traditional Guyanese fudge. He said that producing his own products has always been one of his biggest goals. Let's meet him.
The bread basket was started in 2011. I, at the time, was a mobile vendor riding around on my bicycle, selling mints and other confectionaries. But I wanted to produce my, I wanted to sell my own product. So my mom, she normally would make fudge. So I approached her and asked her if she can teach me how to make fudge. And she so did. And after that, I started making my fudge. And then persons started liking it and the response was great and persons encouraged me. So I decided to sell the fudge exclusively. And the name Red Basket actually came about because of the container that I used to sell the product. It was actually a red basket. It's quite faded now, but at that time it was a red basket. And I wanted the business not to be a hustle, but to be a small business that would grow. When I first started selling the fudge, the response was great. Persons keep encouraging me. They like it. They said to me things like it reminded them of small days. And that encouraged us to stick to the traditional team that we have when we make our fudge products. And persons would suggest, you know, we should try getting it into supermarkets. And we so did. And we were successful into getting our first supermarket in August 2011. And that was DSL Cash and Carry. There were challenges along the way. There were many. But there are ones that really impacted the development of the Red Basket. Financial management, I had to learn how to manage money, and me not having the financial intelligence to manage money in the earlys, the Red Basket would have closed several times, but each time we closed, reopened, and we came better, and we came stronger, more knowledgeable, and able to press forward. I would like to see more businesses that target small upcoming agro-processors, businesses that would do things like have kitchen, commercial kitchen space to rent. That is something that is very important to grow, and also more marketing opportunities and more training opportunities. I see the Red Basket in 5 years as being a household Guyanese name, and we desire to see our products being enjoyed by every Guyanese, whether at home or abroad, by grandma, by mom, dad, and the children. As time progresses, we plan to add other traditional Guyanese snacks to the Red Basket brand, sticking to that theme of bringing Guyanese closer together and having them share the goodness.
Princess Cosbert and Gordon Hunt, like many other agro-processors, experience financial challenges. However, assistance is available. The Small Business Bureau is an agency that assists small agro-processors financially, and the process is fairly simple.
The Small Business Bureau is a semi-autonomous agency that supports small businesses in Guyana. We fall under the Ministry of Business, and our support system gears towards promoting and developing small businesses across Guyana in a holistic way. So we offer financial support, training, general small business advice and guidance, and we also work with other agencies and departments to ensure that small businesses receive the best possible support. We are also mandated to recommend policies to government for small business development across Guyana. The financing offered by the Small Business Bureau is twofold. We work with Republic Bank and Guyana Bank for Trade and Investment, GBTI. We facilitate the process for persons to access loans up to $30 million through those two banks. And loans accessed through the Small Business Bureau have an interest rate of a maximum of 6%, and we also stand up to 70% of the collateral guarantee for most loans. To access any of the services offered at the Small Business Bureau, you must first be an approved small business. And to be an approved small business, you must be registered with the Deeds Registry as either an individual or partnership business or a corporation. Additionally, you must have relevant GRA and NIS documentation, meaning you're registered with those entities, and you also have your compliance documents from those two agencies. Additionally, you must have a staffing of 25 persons or less to be considered as a small business, or also be earning a maximum of $60 million annually. So once you fit within those criteria, definitely you can register with the Small Business Bureau to become an approved small business. When you're approved as a small business, you would be granted a small business identification number, which is unique to your business. And from there, you can access any of the services through the agency. So those services are training, finance, or general business support and guidance. For persons interested in accessing any of our services, we may be contacted at Lot 1, La Penitence, Georgetown, within the National Printers Limited building, or on telephone numbers 226-8120, 8123, 8125, or 8143. We're also on Facebook as Small Business Bureau Guyana, or on Instagram as SBBMKTGY.
Becoming an agro-processor has great potential in Guyana. It is an avenue to help develop entrepreneurs as well as create job opportunities. Uncapped Marketplace is an event created by the Guyana Manufacturing and Services Association to help promote agro-processors and their products. Last year, it was held at the National Stadium and the Leonora Track and Field Center. Many agro-processors participated in those successful events. We will be highlighting some more of them in future programs. You can become a member of GMSA by visiting their office located at Waterloo Street, Georgetown, and simply filling out a membership form. The form can also be accessed via their website. We say thank you to our sponsors who collaborated with GMSA to help make this program possible. I'm Ashley Scotland. Thank you for watching, and do join us again for our next program, Flavours Uncapped, as we continue to highlight more agro-processors. Remember to always support local.